Now he's dusting his skates down and he's getting ready to get back onto the rink. Please give a big loose women welcome to Stephen Booth. So we now.
Hello.
Oh, I'm flustered now.
How are you? Yeah.
I'm very well.
You well?
She's got, look, you've taken all her lip gloss off there.
Yeah, I've got
all
my lips
now. Now she's broody, yeah. Now she's seen
yeah.
you.
Yeah, exactly. So, no, listen, what have you been up to last time we saw you in those slinky outfits?
Oh, yes, the lycra.
They're very nice.
I'm having problems, you know, I can't take it off. Yeah. No, it's been quite busy, actually. I've got an episode in The Royal coming up soon as a guest appearance, and the film that I was talking about last time's come out of the cinema, and it's out in general release on the 19th of March, I believe, back in business, so you must check it out, guys.
We've got a clip, let's have a look.
Have you?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, marvellous.
You mean the robotic arm trainer with a 5-switch wired controller to grab, release, lift, lower, rotate wrist and go 340 degrees. 5 motors and 5 joints allow flexibility. The optional computer interface allows for dual control of robotic arm trainer. 5 axes of motion, the shoulder goes 120 degrees, the elbow moves 135 degrees, the wrist rotates 340 degrees. All with a maximum lifting capability of 130 kilograms.
Precisely.
I'm working on that.
Thank you.
You were good. You were good.
But
I have
no idea what you were talking about.
Oh, you won't unless you watch the film, unfortunately.
No, no, but I have no idea what that was.
It's a PG. It's a right. family. It's, right. it's a real family film, and it's like the ultimate heist.
Okay.
And it's
and what do you do? What's your part? Tell us about
it. I'm playing Travis. He's it's kind of an integral bunch of actors that are playing the sort of hardcore elite. Joanna Taylor, Brian Blessed, Martin mm-hmm. Kemp, Dennis Waterman, myself, and Chris Barry. And we're all kind of
Chris
involved.
Barry.
Lovely guy.
Oh, he's hilarious.
I know.
He's so funny.
Actually, it's very rare to be working on a good project with a good bunch of people. Yeah. That's exactly what they were. And it's just, oh, it's amazing. Pinewood, amazing. It's like a mini city.
But you know what, though? You can't escape the eyes, can you? You're going
it
back.
It doesn't compare
on
to the eyes.
No, the eyes. Yes, actually, we're going on tour.
Yeah.
At the end of March, yeah, and I'm in training at the moment. Christina, my old partner, is beasting me daily at the rink, and it's great. We're getting on better than ever, and it's... Oh, she
does. When you say you're going on tour, do you mean you're going on tour to ice rinks?
No, we're doing an arena tour, hon. We're doing Wembley and on. It's going to be quite big. So, well, basically, the way it started...
You're doing it in the park, on the grass.
Don't be so funny.
What are you talking about?
Do you go to ice rinks? Oh. It's doing ice skating.
It's one of those shows, isn't it? You're going to get a hold of the collar again.
Do you think the standard on this series is higher or lower than yours?
It's much higher. They've raised the bar. I think it might have helped somewhat because they know what to aim for as well. We were kind of going into the unknown last year.
Yeah.
And that's, for me, what made it so special. It's great to be back involved in this project again, working with Torval and Dean and the team that were making it what it was. And the tour's going to be fab. They've got Lisa Scott Lee, Duncan, Bonnie, Claire Buckfield, myself. I'm going to forget people now.
Is there a competition, then?
No,
they're taking the format because they couldn't get... There was so much demand for people to go and see Dancing on Ice. They thought, well, we'll bring it to the provinces and we'll get people out there and have a look at it. So
with judges and everything?
Judges are there, same format as you see on a Saturday night show, and it's going to you. So.
And so will there be voting? Will the people who go there be able to take part in the voting?
Oh, yeah, and they'll be, like I that. Think, don't get me... Actually, I think, I might be wrong, but I think there's a skate-off at the end.
Oh, wow. Oh. Who do you think is going to win this one?
Yeah, have you been watching it?
Yeah. I have, yeah, it was quite hard, because I was actually working with Sheila Ferguson, who you had on the other day.
Oh, wow.
We're doing Panto, and obviously every Saturday, come, you know, 7:30, curtains up, and I was, like, rushing off in between seats to try and catch what was going on and see how Christina was getting on with Stephen and the rest of them. But it's, yeah, I've watched it from the start, and I've been watching reruns, and... It's very exciting, isn't it? You can't beat Dancing on Ice.
I love it.
Why
I've been watching
it
every Saturday. My friend Emily Simons is in it.
It's the danger, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're there every Saturday, aren't you?
I've been quite a few times.
There you go.
You're waiting for something to go wrong. And
no,
you just,
you don't want anything to go wrong.
But you know that there's danger involved. You know that someone might drop.
I know.
They're doing a lift. There's so much jeopardy and so much tension.
I think people are really impressed with people who've never been on ice before can suddenly do these incredible things.
It is amazing.
It's fantastic.
And the flying last year, I just...
On the wires or the... Yes.
Oh, well, that was amazing.
I know, it was my favourite bit. And it wasn't ice skating, I shouldn't be saying that. It's like a childhood dream, being a superhero.
Yeah.
It actually happens, it comes to life.
Like, yeah, fantastic.
I'm 6 metres above ice. I don't want to be here anymore. Yeah.
We were talking about destiny before. Do you believe in destiny?
I do, yeah. I was actually listening avidly earlier on to what you were saying about finding love. And it's a strange thing. I think when you first meet somebody, you can't look for it too hard because you then can't... You want it to be fate and you want things to happen. But if you find somebody and it works and you're getting on really well and things start to happen to you that just shouldn't be happening, I don't know. Like every time my wife and I go on holiday, we like to go to the tropics.
Yeah.
We like to go to really far-flung places in the middle of nowhere, really unbearably hot. Mm-hmm. And I don't know why, there's always rain, but tropical storms and loads of lightning, and it follows us everywhere. Just like England, really.
Well, how did you meet your wife, then?
We met on my first job in Mauritius, which was great. And it was like a six-part drama. And God knows where it went in the end. I'm not sure.
Now, when you fell in love, though, you have to say Mauritius.
Did you know straight away when you saw her or not?
No, I didn't. I thought, you're really interesting. I like you. You make me feel stupid. But it's a strange thing, actually. It's a strange thing. You can get into some relationships and you have, I think for a guy, they don't, I mean, not many men would admit this, and it took me a long time to realise it, but the kind of woman that I'd end up going for in my previous relationships, there'd always be a certain amount of control where I'd be definitely the man and she'd be the woman. But with us, it's a very equal thing. We speak our mind and she's very sassy, Debs. And she doesn't sit back. She always tells me what she thinks, and I love that.
Did you cook for her?
Say again?
Did you cook for her?
Yes, I do.
Oh, good.
But she cooks for me too, actually. Yeah. I do like the odd burnt offering.
Yeah, yeah.
Joke! Yes. I'm sorry, honey, I'm joking.
Yes, you could just be in huge trouble here.
I am in huge trouble.
I think just sort yourself out. Make the apology right now.
Public apology.
Yes,
in front of me. I'm sorry, I really am. No, she cooks a great meal, but actually, no, I follow the Jamie Oliver style of cooking where see what's in the fridge, get a few herbs and spices and whoosh, flash it in the pan and make what's left over good.
Okay.
She's good with the recipe books.
Okay. So well, listen, cool. Say a huge thank you to Stephen Boone.
Oh.
Go to see Dancing on Ice. Okay, well, that's your luck for today and for this week, but never fear, because.